Do you believe in the dragon? Yes, I do. Yes, I do so much. I believe in dragons. I can see dragons. I can feel dragons. I am one with the dragon. You know, many people in our path call themselves dragonkin. Those are people who believe that they are the reincarnated soul of the dragon. You know, many people believe this because they feel very draconic inside of them. When I felt the dragon for the first time, I knew that he was not me. My dragon was not me. But I felt something draconic inside of me. And that is why many people believe that they have the reincarnated soul of the dragon. And they can talk like the dragon, and they are one with the dragon, as they are the dragon. They only have a human body, that's it. Inside of it, it's all draconic. And even though that is not what I believe that there is an energy inside of us that is indeed draconic, but the rest, most of it, is human. And the dragon around us is its guardian. That's what I believe. And you can let this thing, let this energy inside of you grow. It's when you have an awakening, that is when the dragon touches it for the first time. So it's waking up, your energy is waking up and it's growing. But it will never conquer your humanity, your human energy. Your human energy is what you are born with it. And but many other people have their own theory about it, and that's fine. You should think about for yourself what you feel, because you are totally free in what you think. This is only what I think. Everyone has their theory, and this is my theory, but some people just believe that they are totally dragon inside their soul. There is no human thing left. It's only a cover, and they are reincarnated. Even though I don't really believe how reincarnation is, because they say it's you are born again totally as something different, but this energy inside of us, it's much more complicated than that. It's born with us, together with us, and we can see through the eyes of this dragon inside of us. We can learn from it, we can talk to it, we can talk to the dragon next to us because of this. And that is why I don't believe that we are dragonkin, but people who believe this, that's very fine. It's also the path of the dragon, and we have to respect this. Because I cannot speak in a dragon tongue. I cannot. Just to adjust ourselves to the dragon is a whole job to do, a whole lifetime to wait for. To understand the dragon, they are animal and we are human, and everything that we understand of the dragon takes a lifetime. It needs to be understood, and it's so difficult because they are other animals than us, and inside of us there is also this kind of animal reborn also, but this also needs to be understood. Dragonkin, yeah. So the people, oh my god, they are still hunting here in my garden. Oh, let's curse them. So I'll wrap it up. If you feel draconic inside of you, you should have your own opinion on what this is. Explore this, what this is, and whatever you think about it, this is it. You're right, you're always right. When your dragon tells you you are a dragon, that's it, that's okay, that's fine. I won't argue with this if your dragon tells you this. But to me, my dragon showed me my energy inside of me, and showed me the way to grow it. So dragonkin or not, we are all on the path of the dragon, and we all should respect each other.